The ABU RoboCon 2024. Students in the Asia-Pacific region gain various skills every day. These young engineers gather once a year to compete in a robot contest. It is a showdown of their unique ideas and cutting-edge technology. What is needed is knowledge and skills. A fast and stable mechanism. Accurate control. Situational strategies. And what matters most is good teamwork. Participants compete with their pride on the line. This year's arena is set in Quang Ninh, Vietnam, which is rich in nature and faces the World Heritage Site of Ha Long Bay. But in recent years, it has rapidly developed into a logistics and production hub. In August 2024, a heated battle between young contenders took place here in Quang Ninh. 2 days before the contest, 13 teams that won domestic contests in their home countries have arrived at the final venue. Some students look a little tense. While others, like last year's winning team from Toyohashi University of Technology, seem to be more relaxed. 1 day before the contest, the pit area at the venue suddenly became hectic. Preparations for the robot began at a rapid pace. In order to pack the robots in a box for delivery, teams needed to disassemble them in their home country. Therefore, the students must assemble the robots and complete them to their best condition in just 1 day. Since the robots consist of a number of precision parts, they are very delicate. Everyone is extremely serious because an error of just 1 millimeter could change the game result. Test runs begin on the field. The practice field at home and the actual field can be slightly different in materials and measurements, as well as temperatures and humidity. Even slight differences in the environment can have a big impact on the robot's performance. Teams make detailed adjustments during test runs to further improve the accuracy of their robots.
RoboCon với mình thì mình rất nhiều cảm xúc, từ vui buồn có và vui vẻ rất là nhiều, thậm chí là những người đồng đội tuyệt vời rất là nhiều.
It is an honor to be here in Vietnam to represent our country, and we feel very excited, very very fortunate to be here, being a part of RoboCon. Thank you.
The preparation is mostly as what we trained before coming Vietnam, but we still face a few of the problem with the lightning and the different of the equipment for the game. So we are still fixing some problem, and we hopefully we can fix the problem and perform our performance well.
我们今天 发生了几次很重大的失误，可以说我们现在的精神其实是有点沮丧的，因为我们在准备了很长的时间，而且今天也有很多的队伍，比如说日本、越南、香港队，他们也很强的，但我相信我们明天会做到更好的，我们不会放弃自己。
It is really nice to see all of the other countries showing different mechanisms and their designs, and I would love to share their opinion and then discuss their idea of creating the robots.
Finally, the day of the contest. The venue was filled with over 3,000 spectators. Colorful flags of various countries decorate the audience seats.A tense atmosphere in the pit area. Many students continue preparations right up until the start of the event.
ABU Robocon Hai Kong Hai Tu!
Good afternoon, everybody! It's ABU Robocon 2024. Welcome!
The theme of the contest is Harvest Day.Which is based on rice cultivation in Vietnam. This robot named R1 grabs objects resembling seedlings and places them in the designated location. Then R1 collects the balls which represent paddy rice and launches them. The feature of the rules is that the automatic robot R2 harvests the paddy rice and tries to store them in a silo.The robot must automatically assess the situation and place the ball appropriately. When the team successfully cleared all the tasks, it achieves Mua Vang and the team wins. Here comes the game between National University of Mongolia and King Mongkut's University of Technology, North Bangkok of Thailand.Mongolia has been focusing on technology in recent years, and their Robocon skills have improved dramatically. They're aiming for their first victory, putting their national prestige on the line. Meanwhile, in Thailand, Robocon has been very popular for a long time. They also achieved great results in the ABU Robocon.The outcome was a 200-470 victory for Thailand. Next up is between Universitas Negeri Yogyakarta of Indonesia and University of Electronic Science and Technology of China. The R1 robots of both teams plant the seedlings with smooth movements.The collection and launch of the paddy rice also appears to be going smoothly. And the key is storing the balls in the silo. Here, the R2 of both teams with the ball collide. Indonesia blocks China's move, interrupting China from scoring any more points. But China is not giving up.In the end, China won with more points. Semi-final is between Chinese University of Hong Kong versus Japan's Toyohashi University of Technology. Hong Kong has won the championship twice so far. They are training hard, aiming to win this time as well. Japan, on the other hand, is competing in the game with pride as the defending champion. In the end, Hong Kong achieved the Mua Vong victory. The crowd went wild by the fierce game between the two competitive teams. The second semi-final match was between teams from the same Hun Yen University of Technology and Education. The close match continues. In the end, Vietnam won 1450 to 480. And finally, the final match. It is Hong Kong against Vietnam 1. Both teams continue to move quickly and steadily, accumulating points. 1 minute into the game, Vietnam 1 declared a retry. Meanwhile, Hong Kong's momentum continues. 2 minutes passed. Hong Kong is now confident of victory. And the final result, Hong Kong won over Vietnam 1. After the heated game, students congratulated each other on their good performances. In the end, Hong Kong responded to the cheers of the large crowd with a victory lap, a tradition at ABU Robocon.
其實完咗呢個比賽啦，都係算係鬆咗一口氣啦。咁喺呢個比賽度可以同到好多強隊咁樣去交手，其實我哋係好期待，一直以嚟都好期待，同埋好嚴陣以待嘅。但係同時間我哋對於呢個成績，我哋都係意料之外啦，都冇諗過會對住喺咁多強大嘅對手嘅一場比賽入邊都可以攞到一個咁好嘅成績。咁我哋都好 respect 其他隊嘅。咁希望嚟緊有機會可以繼續同佢哋交流啦，係。
On the next day of the contest, students gathered again at the venue for the Friendship Exchange Program. Here, teams that achieved a good result in the contest presented their robot technology and ideas with demonstrations and explanations. Participants got a close-up look at the robots. There were crowds surrounding the strong teams. All who gathered here dedicated their passion to making robots. Teams and nationalities no longer mattered. Young people with the same aspirations come together through frank exchange of information on robots and technology.
啊, tôi tên là Trần Hà Trang, à, tổng đạo diễn cuộc thi ABU Robocon 2024 của Đài Truyền hình Việt Nam. Với cái vai trò của ban tổ chức ấy, thì chúng tôi cũng thấy rằng là để các đội có một cái cuộc thi vừa an toàn, một cái đề thi hấp dẫn và sau cuộc thi lại là những cái buổi giao lưu, những cái hành trình đồng hành với cuộc thi. Một trong những cái kỷ niệm mà tôi nghĩ rằng là tất cả các cái cuộc thi Robocon đều có trải qua tất cả các năm. Đấy là một cái bầu không khí thân thiện, một cái sự sẻ chia, một cái sự quan tâm đối với tất cả các đội tuyển tham dự cuộc thi. Tôi nghĩ đây là một những cái trải nghiệm mà chỉ có thể có ở trong chương trình ABU Robocon.
Thank you.
The students, who had become completely comfortable with each other, enjoyed the fun that only an international competition can offer. The group visited Halong Bay, a World Heritage Site. An emerald green sea and mysterious rock formations are everywhere. For the students who were passionate about robots and fought to the end, the beautiful Halong Bay will be an unforgettable sight.
やっぱりその自分たちと似たような物事を考えていて、こういう作戦が強いね、ああいう作戦が強いよねっていうふうに考えていて、だとこういう問題があるというちょっと大変だよねっていう、そういうトラブルの部分とかもそうですけど、大体今似たようなことを同じような考えを持ってここまでだと突き進んできてるんだなっていうふうのを、あと改めて感じたというか、世界中のいろんな人たち、自分たち同じ年代の人たちがこうやって同じロボコンって一つの優勝に向かって、 ABU ロボコン優勝に向かって、まあ一緒に突き進んでいる、一つのルールの中で、まあいろんなアイデアの中でなんかロボットを作り上げていくっていう、その過程も含めて美しいなというか、本当にそのいろんな人たちのロボットに関、まあロボコンに関する、まあ情熱というのをすごい強く感じましたし、勝っている人たちはすごい喜んでいるし、負けた人たちは本当に悔しそうにしているし、まあそういう感情をそうですね、いろいろと私の、まあ、心に突き刺さりましたね。
It was followed by a farewell party. They danced together to celebrate the last night in Vietnam. The next ABU Robocon will be held in Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia, in 2025. This time, robots will take on a real basketball game. What kind of contest will it be? Stay tuned for the next episode.